were at the airport. I got some ampersand.
Also, as I mentioned previously, this aircraft is sold out.
Sorry guys, it got a little hectic, so we were delayed an hour and a half. On that freaking plane, sitting there. I look purple, I don't know why. Basically, we got here, it's like 2 p.m. But we're about to go find somewhere to eat. Oh, we have to take the bus to go to the car rental place. That's what the lady said.
We're going to a park.
Yeah, so now we're here. Look how beautiful it is. Oh, I love palm trees. Texas can never, for real, for real. Okay, now we're on a super secret top mission. I don't know what the door is doing, but you know how he surprised me last time with an Audi, even though he said he would get me a Nissan Altima? Y'all, look at this.
To Hawaiian Fresh Seafood
look.
Liberty.
Oh, what car is this? No, it's a Mercedes.
Camry.
Mercedes C300. About luxury cars, they tighten the seatbelt, and I think that's the coolest thing ever. It's a little scary. Okay, now we're heading to our first foodie spot. I'm so excited. But we're gonna have really nice reservations tonight.
In a quarter mile.
But our flight got delayed so much that we just don't have time. Even if we skipped lunch, we still wouldn't have time to like get ready and everything. So that's really annoying, but it's fine. We got the shoyu salmon. Hawaiian salmon.
No, there's nothing wrong.
And the garlic salmon. Or sorry, these are our tuna. Okay, so we went to Joe and the Juice in San Diego. It's at the UTC, I think that's what it's called. Or Westfield, I don't know. It's some kind of mall. There's only three Joe and the Juices. Southern California. I thought there was more, but the consensus is the pick-me-up smoothie or juice, whatever, is really good. The vanilla spirulina one is, it tastes like vanilla protein powder. I got the famous tuna cotto. I added jalapeno. It was so underwhelming. That's a cute noise. It was so freaking underwhelming. I'm really disappointed, but I'm glad that I got to try it. By the way, no one ever talks about how that shit is $40. Smoothies and a sandwich.
Yeah, that shit was a little whack.
Yeah, I didn't know it's like Erewhon prices. Well, actually Erewhon would have been $60, but like still.
Turn right to
that's fine. I got to experience it. It was cute in there. And I don't recommend it. Okay, y'all, we made it to the hotel. Sorry, that sounds fake.
No, don't.
That sounds fake as fuck.
I need to shake, so can you read that up?
Okay, we got to the hotel, you guys. We are staying at the Hyatt Regency in Irvine, California. The bathroom is a little bit small, not gonna lie, but it's actually really nice. Like, the features and everything, the marble, the stainless steel. Mirror, most importantly, the mirror. I like when mirrors have this little ring because it makes your makeup look really good and pictures look really good. And of course, you gotta have a full-length mirror, because what are you doing if you don't? And I actually really like this. Look at this hook. Like, and they actually upgraded us to a balcony, all because I just asked, and it was so sweet. And look, they even gave me roses. Well, I'm not a mother, but they were giving out roses for Mother's Day, and they just told Gnor to take the roses and give them to me. So here's a bed. Here's our little couch. And here's our balcony. It's not giving sunny California, but it's still very beautiful. Look at this view. I love her. And there's actually a Punjabi wedding going on down there. There are so many supercars, and wow, I'm really high up. I'm now just realizing that. Look, everything is so gorgeous. Yeah, we're just really excited to be here. Our dinner reservations are at 10:30. Luckily, I made two low-key. I didn't think I would need both of them, which we're not gonna make it to the 7:30 one, which I already canceled at Costa Madeira. But yeah, we're here. Hey, you guys, it's the next day. It is Saturday, May 11th. Yes, so today is actually the wedding day, but we gotta make a full day of being in California, right? So we're going to Venice Beach right now to go to Great White. I really hope we can get in. We're going early, 9:30. I mean, we're gonna be there at 10:30, which is really not early at all. And I'm really, really hoping there's not a long wait because I could not get a reservation. We went to Perch. Oh my goodness, that's actually one of the best dinners I've had in a very long time, and it was actually all really good. We had the steak frites and the Chilean sea bass. It was so good. And oh my god, the white chocolate bread pudding was just like a little piece of bread, oh, with ice cream. Everything there was so delicious. My only complaint is that the service was so slow. Like, I don't know if they were just really busy, and then they, I don't know, like, it took so long to get everything out. The waiter was slow, and like, he was nice or polite, but he was really awkward, so I don't know what that was about. And but they sat us next to like a little fireplace, so it was really cute, and we got a view. Like, they literally did the whole shebang, because I put in the reservation note that it was our anniversary, and then like if they could accommodate the view, and also they give us free ice cream. Sorry, again, we're like brushing his teeth in there. But yeah, so we're doing that, and I don't know where the day is going to take us. I'm really hoping it gets a great white, because I literally have the whole order of what I want to order. And yeah.
Y'all, we got this banana bread. It was so delicious. I didn't film anything else. I'm so sorry.
Okay, y'all, I know I see you guys. Can you even hear me? Hey guys, I always feel like I'm updating you guys in this bed, but we just came back from the wedding, and it ended around like 10 p.m. So now we're just gonna go hang out with the boys and get food, possibly. Let me try to make. Good morning, y'all. It is Sunday, May 12th. Today is our first full day in California. Friday, we obviously came in. Saturday was the wedding. It was so beautiful. Congratulations to Sammy and Manny. Their wedding was perfection. It was so pretty. I just can't even describe it, but I did show y'all a clip of how it was set up. But it was my first Arabic wedding, and it was very lit. But I'm not gonna lie, I got really tired of dancing after like the first few hours. So anyways, today we have a full list of things we gotta get done. Well, first I'm gonna put the NYX brow glue in, because I feel like applying this before you do your eyebrow pencil just makes, it just looks better than doing it the other way around, in my opinion. For my light Asian eyebrows. So today I'm just gonna do my go-to soft glam that I know photographs always well, which includes the Moondust by Urban Decay and Space Cowboy. I'm sure y'all have seen this, it's really popular, but I don't even use any primer because it's just like a super light sparkle. It kind of gives your eye a sparkle, like the actual eye kind of brings out the sparkle in your eye. I don't know how to describe it. You know when people are like the puppy dog eyes? Like, I feel like it kind of does that. I'm in love with the Glow Recipe Plump Hyaluronic Gloss Balm. It is really moisturizing. Like, I really like it a lot more than the Laneige one. Now that we have let the brow gel, I'm gonna brush it out like the excess product, and then just fill in my eyebrows. I'm gonna use this super fine liner from Essence, the Kat Von D tattoo liner. I use this for the actual wing. The other one, I just like the blackness, which they're both black, but it kind of helps me save product. And I also just have those eyeliners that I really like. This is so dumb, but I've had my Canon G7X for so long, like obviously ever since I started vlogging back in 2020. And y'all know how digital cameras are super popular right now, including the G7X. People have been figuring out how to make it look super vintage and just super clear photos that are really nice. Why did I not just figure out I have a flash on my camera? I've had this camera for 4 years.
I'm like honestly so annoyed because I've never looked up a single video of how to use this camera. I don't know why. So now I have a digital camera and I'm one of the cool kids, even though I already had the camera. I just didn't look up a video how to use it. New combination of products. I have not used this. I've been using the Giorgio Armani foundation and I really like that foundation because my skin has gotten really dry recently, and so I had to switch Rusty NARS Radiant Longwear foundation, which I've been using for years, which I'm sure looks fine now, because I've learned to moisturize my skin with this Korean skincare brand called Good Sera. It's their super ceramide cream. Oh my god, it works so well. Also, I don't wash my face in the morning with soap or facial cleanser. I just use water. Let's try the Giorgio Armani foundation. Kind of scared. I used to have really bad acne and stuff like that, but now it's like extreme dryness. I really like this Huda Beauty Faux concealer. It's like the perfect shade match for me, so I kind of use a little bit of that to cover. So I'm gonna add a little bit of this Tarte C concealer that's a little bit lighter. Outdoor event, I love using this because it just looks very natural, and yeah, it just gives like a really pretty bronze. Use the Rare Beauty blush in Courage. The blendability of these blushes is just absolutely amazing. Also, I really love this brush. I don't know where it's from. It Cosmetics. I think it's a blush brush, but it is the perfect brush for liquid blushes. It is the Fenty Beauty Matchstick in Amber. It's a perfect cool tone brown. Okay, next, I really love this powder. It's the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Finish Powder in Medium. One of my favorite highlights, the Amrezy one. I just love how it comes on. The nozzle is always perfect.
Y'all, we just had Easy Street Burgers. I didn't film a single thing, but it's on my TikTok.
Welcome back to Trying Viral Influencer Foods. Today we're at Easy Street Burgers in Los Angeles, California. This place has always been kind of popular, but recently Lee and Cardi B reviewed this. As you can see, it's Keith Lee certified. The menu is pretty simple. They have regular burgers and burgers with jalapenos. We got a jalapeno monster double burger and then the filthy fries. So the filthy fries, they have a patty on it and the other ones don't. They're more like animal style. Let me tell you how well they caramelized those grilled onions. They were so delicious. Literally, these are way better than animal fries, and I get that because it's like an original location and not a franchise, but still, it was so good. This is the Jalapeno Monster Double Burger. They use fresh jalapenos, which I feel like is such a game changer because it's so crunchy, it's so delicious and spicy. Literally, my mouth is watering rewatching this. The bun was so soft and sweet. Not exactly a Hawaiian bun, but it was very close. Gotta wash it down with some Dr. Pepper. I don't think I've ever had a real smash burger, but this was definitely like a 15 out of 10 for me. It was so good.
It was absolutely delicious. What would you rate it?
That was a 10.
He's been giving everything an 8.5, but everything has been a 10 out of 10, except for Joe and the juice.
It's right over there.
Now we're going to Erewhon. This is our OOTD. Where's your outfit from, babe? Is it ASOS?
In my closet.
I turn on the camera, he acts like this, but in real life, it's ooh, boop, 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 boop.
No. Fuck no.
Anyways, my outfit, let me not get copyrighted. My outfit is from Laura's Boutique. The skirt is from Shein. This is from EP Jewels. Love that. We're gonna go to Erewhon now.
Welcome back to Trying Viral Influencer Foods. Today we're at Erewhon. This location was at the Shops at the Sportsmint Lodge in Los Angeles.
I've been to an Erewhon before. The first one I went to was in Beverly Hills. That one was a lot more cuter than this one, but this one was more spacious. So anyways, into the food, I got the coconut cloud smoothie that went super viral a few years ago. This is my first time having it. It's so good. I highly recommend it. And the blue color is just so aesthetic. I wouldn't say it has a strong coconut flavor, but it's still pretty good. Next, I got this drink because they didn't have the Winnie Harlow smoothie anymore, which I was so sad about. So I literally just randomly selected a drink that was displayed next to the cash register. It's a Dr. something. I didn't really like it. I think it had peanut butter in it. That's probably why I didn't like it. I also got a clump of the syrup at the bottom, so I was not very happy about that, but when I mixed it, it tasted fine. So as you can see, I got the sushi platter. That was about $30. I think that's a pretty good deal for all that sashimi and nigiri and a large sushi roll. Here, I was just competing with Gnor because he kept dropping the sushi roll and I was showing him that I was not going to drop it and I didn't. All in all, after my second time at Erewhon, I can conclude that it is very pricey. The quality is there. You're paying for the quality of the food. But let's be real, $70 for this whole meal, including this nasty cookie, I would give Erewhon like a 7 out of 10.
Influencer foods. Today we're at Community Goods. So they're known for their breakfast sandwiches and matcha and tuna sandwiches. But since it was after 12 p.m., I only had the tuna sandwich. By the way, the matcha was phenomenal. It was so good. Even my boyfriend liked it, and usually he's kind of indifferent about matcha. The tuna sandwich was so bomb. It had salt and vinegar chips in it, and it was just crispy lettuce. It was so good. Joe and the Juice Can Never. This is a 15 out of 10.
Now we're being extra fatties. We got street tacos. I was trying to get this traditional Vietnamese dish called bun gat. But they were freaking closed. I think they were closed because of Mother's Day.
Because they love their mother.
So we have
being like suction cut teacher.
El Pastor tacos. They were authentic El Pastor on the little, I think it's like called a trompa thing. They look so good. They even have a fresh pineapple on there.
Okay, I'm so excited. I literally clipped up my hair and everything. It's in there because it's kind of hard. I honestly would say these are the best tacos I've ever had. You think so? This is better than Chilongo's.
Yes.
So these are the best tacos I've ever had. These are so good. I don't think I've had like actual street tacos from the street. Like they were literally tented outside of a Chase Bank. Dude, these are so good. I don't think anything could ever top this. I love onions a lot. Like this. That's a snack. Are you a cricket? Because you just rub your feet together like one? I don't even know what it's called. It had no sign.
So we had a really long resting session. Now we last minute are going to the night market in Asia Garden Mall, which is a really popular market that has been going on for years. I went there maybe like 6 years ago. Okay, so I have made a mistake. I thought the night market was already going on, but they actually don't start until June 14th, LOLs. I went to go get dessert at this place instead. It looks really cool. It's called Cute Cook. They have really cool dessert. We just met up with our friends.
What's the strongest place called?
I don't know. She sent me the link.
Yeah.
Put makeup on because I feel ugly as fuck.
Right now?
Should I?
No. Send it to me quick.
Send it to me, please. Okay, so we're going to the chicken shop. I think in Newport Beach. So I'm excited. I like Newport.
Start the route to the chicken shop.
If we're in Newport,
proceed to Mercantile.
I do want to wear makeup. I'm just put a little bit. Yeah. Okay, now we are in Newport Beach on the pier. We went here last time, but it was super windy, so I literally couldn't even talk.
and we couldn't even hear each other in person too. Oh my god. The smell here. It smells real bad. I'm not gonna lie, but this is really cool. We made it to the San Diego Arte Hotel. Oh my gosh, the lighting is just really bright. But look at this sliding door. Ew. I love the door, but this bathroom looks way better than the last hotel. But the last hotel was really clean. I'll give it that. So I have no complaints about that one. But look at the shower. It is so nice. It's so weird. It has like wood floor in there, but like, I guess the tile wood floor. But it has those shampoos, conditioner, and the toilets in the corner. This is so beautiful. This is my outfit of the day. We just came from La Jolla Cove. It was absolutely beautiful. And look at all this. I like this bathroom because you can adjust the lighting. And this is our view. Look at it. We're in downtown San Diego. It's so beautiful. It's giving downtown. So we're here. I think we're gonna check out the swimming pool right now. We have dinner reservations at 8:30. But this town has so much I want to explore. We're at Lofty Coffee in Little Italy. Look at this latte art. And I got the
cloudy
cold brew, something like that. Oh my gosh. And then this egg tart thing, it looks so good. This area is so beautiful, look nice. I definitely want to come back here. It's just too pretty. And the weather is so nice, even though it's a little bit cold, but just look at it. Look at the view. The only downside is there's a lot of crackheads. Like, kind of scary ones. Anyways, my outfit. Interesting. It's not too sweet.
It's not. It's very creamy.
On this, the other side, not the. Oh my god, my
hair. Use your food.
Your
food.
It's honestly not bad.
It's really good. Mm-hmm. These are cute.
They're cute.
I like the bit.
I
like the simple drink. Like the simple makeup.
Oh, thanks.
I like you getting ready in 20 minutes. It's like 30, but still.
Alright guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the vlog. Just to like summarize everything, because I know it was like very confusing about what cities we were in, and I kind of just want to provide this itinerary for other people, but I do have a full, more detailed explanation of places to eat on my food Instagram, North Texas Gems, in the link or in the bio below. But basically, we landed in San Diego because it was actually a lot cheaper to land there instead of the Irvine airport. I believe it's in Irvine. So we went from there, picked up our rental car, and then drove 2 hours to the Santa Ana, Irvine area, Orange County area. We stayed there the majority of the time, but we explored most of Los Angeles, which is actually an hour away, or to the all the destinations that we want to go to. So we did a lot of driving, spent a lot of time in Los Angeles exploring, and then we drove from the Santa Ana, Irvine area to back to San Diego, because that's where we were flying out back to DFW. San Diego, we got to be there for like one full day. Honestly, you need like 5 days to explore in San Diego, maybe like 4. There's just like so much to see. Like, it's such a good city, high cost of living. I'm sure that's why, because there's just everything there. But yeah, so it was a very good trip. I hope to see y'all in the next video.